Hello and welcome to another Bleistift video, and today I want to show you another unusual pencil sharpener. In the past I've shown the little shaver, then now we had a quick look at Faber-Castell's pencil sharpening knife, or sharpening knife. It's, you can sharpen your pencil with it, you can also scrape things off the paper, let's say lines that you drew or wrote that you want to remove. We got here sandpaper for working with the lead, for changing the shape of the lead. And today I want to show you the Masuba pencil sharpener. I ordered the cherry version, and yeah, I ordered it, I think, more because of the beauty of the object than the desire to sharpen in this way. But what you get is a beautiful box. I ordered the cherry wood box. Let me see whether I can change the light a bit. It's a beautiful color. There's also another color. I think it was walnut, but it looked a bit too serious. I don't know whether the light will look very good. But yeah, it's a beautiful box. And inside, very well made, we got some documents here. Little stickers we can put on the feet. And here we got that pencil sharpening knife. Now, this notch, you know, looks a bit familiar. Now, if you look at electrician's knife, they often have this notch. I don't have an electrician's knife here, but I've got a copy of the Spanish army knife here. And now, that also has a notch, which is, you know, I think normally to strip cables. So in this box, you know, you can keep your knife here. This is the logo from the maker. This is some sort of sandstone. I think they call it inkstone. You know, if you look at East Asian writing traditions, there's some sort of inkstone you can carry with you. Let me just get one. Okay, I'm back. I should have thought of that earlier. But yeah, makes sense to show an inkstone here. So, yeah, you put water there, and it will turn into black ink you can use for your brush. So I think there's supposed to be some sort of resemblance here. Yeah. So I never actually tried out the knife, and I think normally you don't use it to sharpen pencils from scratch. So it might be a mistake to sharpen a pencil from scratch, but I'm gonna try it. Now, I don't know whether it is stainless, otherwise, you know, it might get brown over time from handling it. But on the other hand, that might add to the beauty. You can see here, it goes a bit lower. I think it's mainly for artists. They go out, they create the point of the pencil how they want it, and they can then you know, keep the shavings in there until they've got an opportunity to dispose of it. Okay, let's use a Staedtler khaki cutter pencil. I thought that's a fitting pencil. And I hope I won't quite make a fool out of myself, because, like I said, this is probably not for sharpening from scratch. This is probably made for manipulating the tip of your pencil. Okay, this is surprisingly easy to cut. I'm not sure whether the knife is so sharp, because, and to be fair, it didn't look sharp. It's just compared. Is it the wood? I think the knife is really good. The pencil sharpening knife is really good. Didn't expect it to be quite that good, but yeah. Okay. Well, not sure how you you can sharpen it. I guess you could have use a, you know, a sharpening stone, one with a acute angle, like a triangular one or something, like a Spyder-Core sharp maker or something like that, and move it along possibly. Okay. Here's the graphite. Well, I'm positively surprised how good the blade is. Let's do the rest here. So this seems to be a thin plate of metal. I've seen similar materials. Some of them have tiny diamond particles on them. Like there's the one called, is it called duck food or bird food? I wanted to show it for quite a while, for many years, because it's actually suitable for sharpening pencils and suitable for sharpening the knives that sharpen pencils. Anyway. Okay, maybe this is a little bit too slow. Let's try that. Don't want to break anything either. Maybe I should just pretend that I wanted a point like this. Well, yeah. Just woke up my computer, in case you hear a noise. Touched the mouse. Come on. Okay. So, let's just get some paper. Yeah. Here's some scrap paper. Yeah, so I'm not an artist. I'd have to look into all the different ways of manipulating a lead point for different purposes, but that pencil sharpener is certainly a beauty, and I certainly don't regret the purchase, because the knife works so much better than expected. I've got to thank Steven of Pencil Talk fame, because I found out about this pencil knife when he told Gunther and me about it. So thank you, Steven. Okay, thank you very much for watching, and until next time, goodbye.